Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. In this video, I am going to share with you three tips on how to shrink large fibroids naturally. I'm so glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knudsen and I'm a certified holistic health coach and I coach women on how to heal naturally from female related conditions. If this is your first time joining me, welcome. And if you like what you see, please consider subscribing and hitting the notification bell so you never miss an episode. In my opinion, there's not much difference between large fibroids or small fibroids, except for the length of time that it's going to take you to shrink it. But let me just caution you here. No one can tell you how long it will take for you to shrink the fibroids that you have. Every person's body is different and they are going to respond differently. There's no way to tell. But I can just tell you if you have a 2 centimeter fibroid versus a 20 centimeter fibroid, that's going to take a difference of time just because of the size. So I just wanted to get that out there in the open first off. So let's just get right into the topic. The first thing I'm going to say, you guys probably know what I'm going to say because I'm always saying it, and you have to deal with what you are putting in your mouth. You've got to get rid of the things that contribute to growing fibroids in the first place so that you can attack the actual fibroid. So we want to get rid of the foods that are creating toxicity and estrogen dominance in the body. So that is the meat, the dairy, the alcohol, the caffeine, the processed foods, the sugars, the grains, things like that. If you want the list of foods to avoid, you can click in the cards above and or down below to get a copy of the free download. And I know I listed off a lot of things that you would probably like to eat, but in order to give yourself time to heal, you probably need to get rid of them. I won't say probably, I'll say you need to get rid of them for a while so your body can release the toxicity that is accumulating in your body that causes fibroids to grow. And you might be saying to yourself, Chelsea, you have taken away everything that I can eat. And for most people, that seems very true, but it's really not true. We just have to learn a new way. So on my channel, I have lots of recipes that you can eat that are compliant to helping your body to release fibroids naturally. You can look on my Instagram page where there are pictures of foods that I eat on a regular basis to give you some ideas of what you can eat. I also have recipes on my website at whatchelseaeats.com. You can also purchase my 7-day meal plan that will give you some ideas of what you can eat. You will not starve if you give up those foods to avoid. That's all I'm trying to say here. It's just learning a new way to eat. And you're worth it. You're worth taking care of yourself. You're worth learning that new way so that you can be well. The one thing that I often tell people is, you know, you can go ahead and get the surgery that will, you know, cause the problem to sort of go away for a little while. Like, at least you won't have this big bulging fibroid in your stomach. You won't be struggling with heavy bleeding if that's something you struggle with. You won't have some of the symptoms that you have struggled with. But let me just tell you this. Going and cutting out the fibroid is not the answer. You still have to deal with the root cause of the problem, which is toxicity in the body, the stress in your life, the things you put in your body, whether it be water, the air you breathe, the skin products that you put on your body. You have to deal with the emotional roots, all these things you have to deal with. Cutting the tumor out or the uterus out does not solve the problem, because what will end up happening is the things that were going on with the fibroids, the root cause of the fibroid, what caused the fibroid to get there, will end up manifesting some other problem in your body. The root cause of the problem is still there and something else will manifest in your body somewhere else, whether that be cancer, high blood pressure, diabetes. I mean, the list goes on of what can happen in the body if you don't deal with the root cause as to why you got the fibroid in the first place. So cutting it out, cutting the uterus out doesn't work, as well as getting a myomectomy. If you still don't deal with the problem, you don't know how many women I've talked to that said 3 years ago, 6 years ago, 10 years ago, I got a myomectomy and the fibroid grew back. So you have to deal with the root cause. The number two tip I'm going to give you is that you've got to work on the mindset as it relates to changing your lifestyle. A lot of people hear me say, you need to change your diet, you need to change this, or you need to change that. They're just kind of like, are you crazy, Chelsea? I'm not changing all of that. I can't do that. I'm not living without my chicken. I'm not living without this. I'm not living without that. When all actuality, all those things are the reason why you're in the situation in the first place. So why would you put more importance on keeping those things versus trying to make some changes in your life that is going to help you live a better life, give you a better quality of life, help you to enjoy your life more? What I think it is that we have become so attached to the way we have learned to live over these years. It's just kind of like, that's impossible. I can't change it. So we have to get, if we want to make changes in our life, we have to get to a place where we're just kind of like, okay, let me evaluate what I've got going on here and really what is happening in my life and how can I readjust some things so that I can have a better quality of life. And, you know, just kind of really sit down and really think about it and just saying to yourself, am I worth doing that? And is it worth doing all of that? Like, what will this do for me if I change it? So let me just give you a little bit of information about my own life. These situations with these fibroids, I was so sick that I wasn't living. I always shrank back from doing things, extracurricular activities. One, because I was always depressed, or at least maybe not clinically. I wasn't clinically depressed, but I always felt down or just felt bad about myself. Just never wanting to fully live. I was always hiding and shrinking back and just not participating in life the way I needed to. I never felt good. My hair was constantly on the verge of falling out. It didn't quite look quite right. My skin was never right. Like, I always was concerned about my outer appearance and how I was feeling, and everybody had to, you know, sort of adjust their life to fit my dysfunction. I mean, it's more than that, but that's it as a whole. But I was like, I wasn't even living, and I'm a young woman still. And this has been going on my whole life, pretty much. It just got worse whenever I got into my 30s. And I had to change my mind about what I was doing. If I wanted to live a healthy life, then I needed to change what I was putting in my body. I needed to change what I was putting on my skin. I needed to change what I was thinking. I needed to change what was going on in my heart. Like, y'all know I'm a Christian and I believe strongly in the Lord. Like, He is everything to me. But God is not a God that will make you do anything. He is not like, He's not like that. He'll present the opportunity to you. He'll give you some options to choose. But if you don't choose to walk through the doors that He opens for you, He's not going to make you do it. You're the one that's going to have to make the choice to stay miserable. And for a long time, I did that until I changed my mindset around this food. At first, it was like I had a pity party about how everybody else got to eat whatever they wanted, and I had to eat this, that, and the other, and it's boring, and blah, blah, blah. And that was just food addiction talking. I'm just being honest. And so I had to adjust and actually make the changes if I was going to live. Today I live. Today I participate. Today I'm full of energy. Today I'm not depressed. You know, like, I'm in control of my emotions, you know, not like my life is completely different. And it's because I work on changing my mindset all the time. I made one decision that I was going to change my mindset, but it took work because that old mindset was full of lack, defeat, discouragement. It was terrible. I had to change it to a positive God mindset. I had to start thinking thoughts of the way He thought about me versus what I was actually thinking, which was terrible. I thought terrible thoughts about myself. So I had to change that. If you want to be healthy and free, you're going to have to change it too. I don't think there's any way of getting around it. If I could have found a way to get around it, I think I would have found it, and I'd probably be sharing it with you or not. I don't know, but I'm just saying. Most people, though, they don't change. Most people find it easier to stay in their crap than to pick themselves up by their bootstraps and walk into the path that God has for them. It's so much easier to, it seems so much easier to just stay where you're at versus changing. And last but not least, commit to learning everything that you need to learn in order to change this situation in your life. You can shrink large fibroids. It takes a while, but you can do it. So commit to learning everything you need to learn for your path. Now, I offer a path, but there's lots of coaches out there that offer a path. One of the things that I would love to caution you about is going from this one to this one to this one to this one to this one and this one, and then trying to pull it all together, and then you're confused and you're saying this one says this and this one says that and this one says this and I don't know what to do. Well, of course you don't know what to do because there's all this conflicting information on the internet, and who knows if it's all right or if it's all wrong. Only you can make the choice as to which one is going to fit your lifestyle. So for example, you're the one sitting here watching me. If you like what I teach, learn everything you can about what I teach. Learn by watching all of my YouTube videos, joining my group program, looking at all of the resources that I have available, joining my Foods to Avoid to Shrink Fibroids Naturally Facebook group. Ask me questions when you can. And engage yourself in it if you like what I say. But if you don't, if you like Susie Joe down the street, who is a different coach and she coaches on the same type of topics, do the same thing with her. Find out what you can learn from her. And once you've learned everything that you need to learn, commit yourself. Commit yourself to the process. Stick to it. Stay focused. So if you have committed to the program that I offer, focus in on it. Do it for 6 months. Don't go back and forth all over the place trying all kinds of different things. Focus on it for 6 months and then take a step back, reevaluate what you've done, see what's working. If this part is working, keep it. If something else isn't working, do an adjustment and then work some more until you're better. All I'm saying is learn what you've got to learn, pick something, commit to it, and focus on it and do it consistently and see what happens. But I believe that it's possible that you can pick any of these coaches that's available out here. Pick the protocol, do it with all of your heart, and you will see results. I just believe that that's possible. So, but what I find that most people do is that they're all over the place. And so because they're symptom driven, oh my goodness, this month the bleeding didn't go down, so it must be something wrong with the process. So let me go try this process or that process. Oh my goodness, you know, like all over the place. You got to remember, you got into this situation after years of treating your body like goodness knows what, and you expect to be on a program for 1 month and for all your problems to be over. It doesn't happen like that for everybody. Some people, you know, can, you know, their whole life is turned around in 1 month and they're like feeling great. But some people, it takes them 6-7 months for them to start feeling better. It just depends on the person. you have to be focused. So now you know three of my tips on how to shrink large fibroids. I hope this video has been helpful. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, y'all, take care.